That's when he goes in. But that chorus is fucking trash. That is the worst.
The Weeknd. We got Starboy. We haven't talked about The Weeknd.
We haven't, because I was waiting for the video last week, so we can talk about it now. I watched the video. I fuck with it. The song's really fun. I've been playing it a fair bit. The video takes on the approach of him destroying the old Weeknd, you could say.
Yeah, I love that.
Destroying all his records and all the awards he's done and everything. And it's kind of like, this is the new me. This is the direction I'm heading in. I've got to where I want to now. So this is my next journey, my next chapter. So I really like that.
Chapter 4 is what we call this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Chapter 1, you know, chapter 1, yeah, the mixtapes, Kiss Land, Beauty Behind the Madness. Chapter 4 is this. Right, this album, Starboy. Now, symbolic of this change, once again, he's deleted all his posts off Instagram. He's done that every now and again. He cut his motherfucking hair, you know.
That's to confirm the change, really.
Confirmed, obviously.
I miss his hair, man.
He looks good. You know what happened the last time he cut his hair? He did dropped some Thursday, the mixtapes. That's when last time he had short hair.
That's my favorite one, too.
And I think it's really smart the way he's laying out the rollout of his album, Starboys. November 24th is coming out. You know, very methodical. You know, he did his interview first with V-Man. I got it right here. Then he's got new clothing merch up on his store, which has been releasing now. He has a deal with Puma, with a clothing line and Puma shoes. He's got the music video out. It's all like methodical. Right? A couple of days after each other. He's got the release date out. There's posters coming up worldwide all over the place. And then he has his debut on SNL doing Starboy and False Alarm. Both.
I haven't heard False Alarm.
Oh, you haven't heard False Alarm?
No.
You're about to hear it, son. Woo! This is a first reaction listen from my man.
All right, so let me get lubed up.
Do you want to hear Starboy first?
Yeah. Get Starboy going. I fucking love that song.
You know what it is.
Yeah.
How he starts
it. Yeah.
He kills himself. And when I saw this, how excited I was.
You were just like, whoa, what's next?
I mean, like, who's under there? That's like, I'm wondering, like, and then
you see it.
You see it's himself. And you know this has to be created, like, over weeks and weeks, because he had the hair that he didn't have the hair. They have to shoot that twice. Mm-hmm. And then when he zooms up.
Yeah, this bit right here.
You're like, who is this? And he's got the
See, I knew already it was going to be him because I'd seen the album cover. I also kind of like how he's got the cross destroying everything, but it's kind of like salvation. Because that's what the cross sort of stands for. Like, I died, like, it's kind of
religious.
So it sort of fits in with the whole commitment itself as well.
These are all his cars, by the way.
Really?
Yeah.
This man must be rich as fuck, man.
And he's got really good taste. Yeah. Like, it's McLaren. How so empty need a centerpiece? $1.2 million car.
We have so much money.
And see, that's a panther, I believe. That's a panther in the car.
Yeah, it turns from a cat to a
cat to a panther.
It's so simple.
Well, to me, it symbolizes the evolution of him.
Like having a pet cat now, he can like afford a pet panther, or
I don't think so much from a finance standpoint, but more of from like an evolution, because a cat, obviously, you know. Cat, it's not.
But a panther
is an aggressive, proud, majestic animal. And
so it's kind of like him evolving. Where how far he's come?
100%. And let it be like, let's not ignore the fact that puma and panthers are both very similar animals. Yeah. He's got to deal with puma.
Is that a real panther though? Surely
no, it's CGI.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
There's a panther chilling. Is in the fucking side.
No, I couldn't believe that they can do that shit.
I mean. It's pretty good CGI, but, and if we talk about this idea of Starboy.
33 million views already? Fucking hell.
Yeah, man.
Weeknd gone big.
51,000 comments, get the fuck out of here. And if we talk about this idea of him being a Starboy, it's kind of like, I think I take it like two ways. It's like, I'm a motherfucking Starboy, like, look what you've done to me, look what I've become. The Starboy to me is like some famous person who's now a star, you know, a celebrity, you know, obviously something far from what he used to be 3-4 years ago. Now I'm a motherfucking Starboy, he's singing it, look what you've done. So he says, look what you've done, you know, I think he's talking to himself, what his music has done, and he's talking to his audience, look what we've done and what we've created. In a good and bad
way. Look how far we've come.
Right. But, and then him smashing his shit as he's singing I'm a Motherfucking Starboy.
And that was really his awards?
I definitely think they had to recreate it. Because you have to do that scene a couple times. But, you know, well, who knows? He doesn't do interviews much.
Another good thing I like about him. Very private man.
Yeah, you know, he doesn't reveal too much. He's smashing his shit. I'm a Motherfucking Starboy. Look what you've done. Look what you've done. Look at all these awards. Be behind the madness. Can't feel my face. Look at all this. I think it's symbolic of he's done with this. Now, when I saw the title for False Alarm, because this is kind of a poppy direction. It's not like Can't Feel My Face, but with Daft Punk on the feature and production, it's a direction that is different, but it's still kind of got that upbeat vibe to it.
So the album's called Starboy.
It's called Starboy.
So this is a confirmed track in there, but it was False Alarm confirmed in there as well.
False Alarm is the third track. It's the first track.
How do you know it's the third track?
Because it's on iTunes. It's an 18-track album.
I didn't even know this.
It's an 18-track album. Starboy's 18 tracks is coming out.
I thought he'd take a while to wait after the success that Beauty Behind the Madness got. I thought he'd take a 2-year break.
Yeah, man.
But no, The Weeknd's like, let's fucking do this.
It's back to work. And you know, this sounds nothing like all the leaks that happened 3 months ago.
I think also the fact when you're like at that stage of fame where he was around the sort of Kissland stage, he wasn't big enough that he could work with anyone. So now that he is big enough that he can work with anyone, that could be a reason that he wants to work so quickly as well, because so much more has been opened up to him through the success of his last album.
Yeah.
Like so many more producers he can work with, pretty much any artist he can work with now.
Yeah, man, he's got Kanye. Mm-hmm. He's got his pick now. And when I see the title False Alarm, I'm thinking, it's a poppy track. I wonder if False Alarm's going to go in a completely different direction and be like, oh, False Alarm, guys, I'm not actually doing... This is kind of like an ode to my previous self, Beauty Behind the Madness self, except in a different direction. Now you're going to hear some shit. That's what I thought. That's what I think. That's what I thought.
Am I gonna like this? I know what I'm expecting to hear after hearing that.
Yeah, especially after the title tracks.
We got.
By the way, this is Asta. What's her name? I'm thinking he's about to do some crazy shit right here. What's her name? She's an Ethiopian singer, Asta Aweki, and his mother and grandmother used to play this and a lot of Ethiopian music. This actual woman, so he sampled her to finish the song as probably an ode to his family.
Are you ready for it?
Please, man.
Starts the track off beautifully. The pre-chorus is great when he like starts to up his voice, the layers on it, when he starts talking about the when he gets up to it's a dark philosophy, those last four bars, that's when he goes in. But that chorus is fucking trash. That is the worst fucking chorus. It went from like a beautiful song, and he's already said the false alarm thing, like he's got the sort of that behind the track, and then he's just chorus false alarm, hey, and then he just like adds some fucking banging bass and some guitar, and it just sounds fucking horrible. I think he just turned from what could have been... I mean, hey, I can't find myself liking that song again because that hook is terrible. But the rest of that song is great. It was good. I just don't like the chorus. Can you see where I'm coming from?
No, I do see it's...
Because that pre-hook is great.
Now, when the scream comes in, we're not used to hearing that. It's like very punky. It was like a very most punk track that I've heard by the week.
Well, yeah. See, I was actually excited this because I kind of like when he did the scream and I was expecting something. But because the hook is just so monotonous... And it's just screaming what the title... Well, he's already talked about it before. It's just... I just felt he could have done more with that. He could have put different lyrics in. He could have switched up a bit. Just the fact is just that screaming and then just him saying that with Hey Hey, it just didn't really roll well with what else he was going
on
about. And
what confuses me more is this was produced by Doc McKinney. And who helped produce the mixtapes. It's more upbeat than what I'm used to seeing from Doc, from The Weeknd, that is. And, you know, production cool. But even the lyricism, I'm gonna say, like, it's nothing special. It just seems once again, The Weeknd superficially talking about a woman's struggles with her materialism and with money and the fame and all the intertwinings of that and the pressure that comes with that. I didn't think it was talked about to a sophisticated level at all,
yeah,
or something that was really different or special. It's pretty basic to me. And let it be known, like, I've been fucking with this man for years, so let it be known, I have a tendency to ride his dick.
Mm.
But I don't want to do that this time, because, I don't know.
Yeah, it's just, I just feel like he could have pulled that off better. Like, he could have, with the chorus, like, keep that exact same sort of, take out a lot of that bass, keep the sort of guitar on the screen, but, like, actually sing scream in that. Don't just say the same shit, I don't know. I'm just not a fan of that sort of hook. But, yeah, I'm not going to say it's bad. Like, he still does his thing on there.
You know what I noticed? The verses are really short. Like, this is like a 7-bar verse.
Yep, and then the pre-hook and the hook's the same whole time. So, does he have 2 verses and one like, bad, like, outro?
2 verses.
A bridge. There you go. And the rest is just all the same.
I feel like this is...
It's filler.
Pretty lazy. Like...
I need The Weeknd to actually come up to me. I'll be like, hey, Abel, what were you thinking about? What does that hook mean to you? What does that hook do for that song and do for the rest of the album? If you explain to me how, and it makes sense to me, I can dig that.
Yeah, you can respect it.
It's kind of like before with the Jay-Z thing we talked about. Gave me a reason, respect it, can see it for what it is.
100%. But
I don't see it for what it is.
Like...
So let's feel like with the end when he goes, it's a false alarm to me. She's a false alarm. That's fine. Like, that's kind of like putting it in there. Like, but then it just goes on.
That's right, because, like, it's any girl that's reciprocating love to you is merely a false alarm, more likely driven by some other superficial materialistic need.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. That's nice.
That's fine, okay, then.
Cool. But then, what's on now? Hey.
Were you looking at me just like, is he digging it?
I didn't want to, like, spoil anything.
Yeah.
How you gonna feel?
Because I was getting into it. I really was until then.
Yeah, this is a... I look forward to hearing more from it. I hope he doesn't miss too much.
See, I'm still excited because even though I didn't fuck with this track a lot, the direction he's going is different. And that's what I like about
100%.
Him. He's taking a complete different direction. And I respect that. And I hope I like a lot more of what he's got to offer.
100%, man.
Mm-hmm. Don't judge a man just by one track. It's probably going to mean...
Or 2 tracks. This is the third track. We've hit 2 tracks out of 18.
Starboy's dope.
I hope he doesn't release too many singles. I hope maybe only one more. Or maybe nothing. I'd be fine with nothing because I want to come in
clean.
Fresh, clean.
Or maybe you could just avoid all leaks. If another track leaks, we listen to it?
This wasn't leaked. This is official release.
Ah.
As you can see by the cover.
It's kind of weird he released it so soon after Starboy.
It was a week.
Like, the Starboy is a great track. Let that ride. Like, why would you put False Alarm out so close after Starboy?
Well, considering the release, we are coming for a November release. So we really is not that many weeks. But I see your point. Outside of that little critique, I think he's been really smart about the way he's handled his promoting and marketing strategy. Always keeping himself in the media.
I'd like to know why he wants to release the album this November. Like, has he had this plan for a long time? Of course, he's been recording, but like...
Good question.
Like, why didn't he wait till next year? Because he could have taken this year off. Why does he feel like he has to release this November? Is it his label? Is it him? Like,
that's a good question.
Mm-hmm. And maybe he doesn't want to release it this November.
You think he's being played and forced in some ways?
Well, yeah, he's at a stage of his career where he's probably his biggest, only to get bigger, if so. But I think The Weeknd's sort of person that doesn't let himself get played. Because, he's, you know, that's why he's a private man. I just feel like he doesn't really give a fuck about too much. I'm pretty sure that when he signs to a label... He'd probably lay down how he feels and what he does, like.
I see Beauty Behind the Madness is something he felt like he had to do, something he had to get rid of out of his system. You know, he knew what he was doing. I think he's very self-aware of what he was doing, what direction he was going, and the effect it would have after he started working with Max, producer.
Mm.
And as soon as that is out, I think he had his eyes on this, and even before that was out, I think he had his eyes on this. We'll see, man.
Maybe he really wants to make this sort of album. Maybe that's why he hasn't taken much time off at all. Maybe it's just him just being like, look, I really want to push this. This is what I want to do right now. I don't want to take a break.
I mean, how long?
A month.
Yeah, a bit over a month. It's almost like, it's weird. It's like almost like I've already got a taste of The Weeknd last year. Like, I'm not that excited because it hasn't been that long.
Yeah, I like a good way. I like when artists really take their time.
Like TLOP. Like, man, when we're in theaters waiting for that to play.